So today we're at Animal Kingdom. So we haven't been to Animal Kingdom in a while, so we're all excited. We just went through bag check, but it was pretty cool. You just walk through something, which is really cool, and they don't check your bag.
But there is a bag check, but if you want to do bag check, if you don't want to go to the big machine. And it's really cool because the big machine can show what's in your bag.
Yeah, which is really cool, what I thought. It's we're gonna go into the Pandora world.
Yeah, so
with that, let's get it started. So we are about to go through tickets, so where you have to scan. And my dad's getting them out right now. It looks pretty cool. And there are a lot of markers where it says, please wait here.
So girls.
Yeah?
After 6 months, how did it feel to walk through a park again?
It feels weird. It felt weird because there was a lot of mocking and you didn't put your hand on the thing, so you just tapped your thing and then you walked by. That felt really weird.
Yeah. And when I scanned it, I wasn't sure what to do, so it was really weird. So
that's why I went last, because I was watching you guys how I could do it.
Oh, that's pretty smart.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
Dude, the bird just got a worm.
Which one?
That one.
Oh, and it just pooped.
Thanks. Oh, well, that is cool.
Okay, so what do you think so far?
It's really good. We're almost there where we want to do a ride.
I'm gonna wait. Okay, you ready? Okay, let's go. So as we walk through the line of flights of passage, I've noticed every 6 feet, there's these markers that say, please wait here, through the entire queue line. I don't know, I kind of want to keep these here. Give me my space.
I'm already tired of walking.
Well, yeah, but would you rather walk than, or wait?
Walk.
Yeah, I'd rather walk too.
Where am I going?
Where are you going? Just keep following the markers on the ground. Oh, you got the shields up here. Nothing? It says, please do not touch.
That was quick, but we just have to wait a little bit more. Because it's a 10-minute wait.
But that's not too bad, right?
Nope.
Walk right up?
Yep. But now we just wait for 10 minutes. Okay. But we keep on walking. We don't stand here for 10 minutes. It says, please wait here.
Okay.
Because I know how to read now.
Well, that's good. How long have you known how to read?
For 2 days.
For 2 days?
Well, maybe for 4 days.
4 days. All right. So you've been an avid reader for 4 days.
Yes.
Got it.
But I still don't know how to read chapter books.
Okay. So we know how to read, just not chapter books.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm a little nervous for the ride.
Why?
I don't know.
You've been on it before.
I know. It just seems like forever.
It's really cool, but the thing that is really scary is right there is a dead guy in water, and that's the scary.
Well, he's not dead.
Is it a statue?
No, it's an avatar.
What's an avatar?
What's an avatar?
Yeah.
It's something that's created. That's pretty neat, huh?
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
That guy, Nellie's?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's an avatar.
Yeah.
I like the plexiglass. Crunch.
It's really cold in here, but we're almost about to be on the ride.
Are coming up now.
So we just went on Pandora for our second time,
and it was really fun.
I'm not sure if you guys could see it or not, but it was really cool. For our second time, it felt like because we were up higher, it felt like we were going down more. Mm-hmm. And now we're going to go on this safari. So let's go. So there's this bridge that leads out of Pandora, right? Pandora? And it's a little secret way we like to take if we go into Pandora.
Where does it lead to?
It leads to like the Festival of Lion King, and it leads to like the Festival of Lion King is. And where the safari is, because we're gonna go on the safari. So it's a little nice shortcut to the safari. And there's a very, very pretty view of the water, and characters like to go below the water. It'll be nice to just sit and watch them go by here. So here we go. On to Jafari. It's a 15-minute wait, and you will see animals on the Jafari.
Safari?
Safari.
Jasmine, how do you say that word? How do you say hippo? No. Beshi says it a whole bunch. Kibuku. Puma? All right. Ooh, I don't know about this one. Mbana, sure. Mbana, Mbani, maybe?
Okay, and inside we go. And it is an outside ride. So, are you excited?
I am, I like the safari.
Are you excited? Okay, let's move up.
Land. Did you know that? Do you know that hippos are faster than humans? 30 miles per hour.
Did you get the difference?
Yeah. We are on the sail.
Asante sana, as we say in Harambe Twende, which means let's go. Alright, Ojama, ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard. My name is Angela, and I'm going to be your safari guide here on the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. Couple requests as we're heading out. First and foremost, I do need everyone to remain fully and completely seated, keeping your hands and arms inside the vehicle at all times. I also need to remind everyone to please keep those face coverings on throughout the entire safari. Looks like there is an okapi there over to the right-hand side, as well as some greater kudu up here on the hill on our left. Now, the greater kudu are one of the taller antelopes here in Africa, about 55 inches at the shoulder. And that okapi to the right may look like it would be related to zebras with the stripes on its legs, though they are the only living relative to giraffes. And up here on the left, once more on the hillside, are the bongos. These darker copper-colored antelope are so shy, they've been given the nickname the ghosts of the forest. Looks like there is a black rhino coming up, laying right along the canyon wall on your left-hand side. Unfortunately, a very rare sight. Due to illegal poaching, there are fewer than 5,000 black rhinos remaining in the entire world. Pretty heartbreaking, they are an incredibly powerful animal. At about 3,000 pounds full grown, black rhinos are capable of charging at speeds of around 35 miles an hour. Not to mention, their skin is about an inch thick, making them nearly impenetrable to most types of natural attack. That means that rhinos don't really have any natural predators, and their biggest threats do come from people. A couple of hippos in the water now on your left-hand side behind the island. A whole group of hippos is called a bloat. On the island itself, the big white birds are pink-backed pelicans. They get their name because during mating season, their backs will turn pink. Crocodiles can reach about 16 feet in length, weighing 500 pounds. They can run at about 10 miles an hour on land. That's just how good along. Painted dogs laying down. African painted dogs get their name because of the beautiful patchwork that they have all over their coats. They may look cute and cuddly, but they are nothing like your domesticated pets. They are one of the most successful hunters here in Africa. More so even than the big cats, what happens is they'll work together as a pack, and they'll chase their prey until it completely wears itself out and drops from exhaustion. Over to your left, kind of by some of the trees, you'll see some sable antelope. They are the emblem for the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. Rather than fleeing at the first sign of trouble, sables stand their ground to fight to protect their own against most any predator.
What are zebras doing at least?
Now, there are a few ways that you can distinguish the Hartman's Mountain Zebra from their other counterparts. First and foremost, take a look underneath their neck there. They have a small, what's called a dewlap. It's a small extra flap of skin that helps them to regulate their body temperatures. They're the only zebra species that will have that. There are, however, other antelope species that will have a dewlap. Another couple of ways you can tell them from their other two zebra species is that they have that nice white underbelly, and their stripes are quite a bit thicker towards their backside than they are towards their head and their neck. They're almost kind of like puzzle pieces that don't quite fit together.
Drift, looking at you, Nobles.
Looks like some wildebeest grazing up ahead as well, the white-bearded wildebeest. Wildebeest is an Afrikaans word meaning wild beast. You may have also heard them referred to as gnu, G-N-U, for the grunting sounds that they make. Naturally.
Sí, demasiado lento.
As we come around the corner as well, if you'll take a look into the grove of trees, you may see some very large horns which belong to the Ankole cattle.
There's the other one.
Now their horns can grow to be about 6 feet in length from tip to tip.
Wow. Right there. How cool is that?
It was. Can
you smile?
Wow! Now those Ankole cattle back there with those very large horns, like I said,
cool.
They
that
can be about
cool
6 feet in length from tip to tip. If you look closely out there in the water, you may see some flamingo chicks, kind of the fuzzy gray ones. As you can see, flamingos do not hatch pink. They'll hatch gray initially, and it does take about a year or two of being on that diet with beta-carotene in it for them to fully reach their pink color. White rhinos are a bit larger than black rhinos, tipping the scales right around 4,000 to 5,000 pounds, still capable of charging at speeds of 35 miles an hour. They do, however, have very poor eyesight. You can only see about 10 feet in front of them. And it looks like on our left-hand side, if you look a little bit further ahead here, kind of between these last two trees, there is a couple of cheetahs up here laying in the dirt. Cheetahs are one of the fastest moving land mammals, clocking in over 60 miles an hour. But they really can't keep up their top speeds for too long, no more than a few hundred yards or so. If they do try to run too far, too fast, they actually completely wear themselves out. There, right up by the rocks, there's actually a warthog laying down there, and a second one laying in its burrow. down here between the broken logs. Warthogs are the largest burrowing land mammals. They use their snouts, their hooves, and their two sets of razor sharp tusks to dig their very large burrows. When they go to sleep like that, they do like to back themselves into the burrows with their tusks facing outward to protect themselves. Going on here on the reserve to help make sure that these animals are as protected as they can be.
That's cool, that's new.
Now we are doing the best that we can to help all of these incredible.
So we are finished with the safari and we're going to, it's tough to be a bug, which Janelle and me have no idea what it is. So we're gonna go check it out.
Here girls, you just got off the safari. What'd you think?
I think it was...
You can take your mask down if you need a break.
I think it was fun. The most cool part was three giraffes ran across the road, which is really, really cool.
Yeah? What'd you think?
Yeah.
What was your favorite animal?
The leopards.
The leopards?
Cheetahs.
The cheetahs. Why? Don't put your fingers in your mouth. That's why you have on a mask. That's why she has, and kids have on masks, because if you take it down, they'll stick their fingers in their mouth.
Just a few reminders. Please wear a face covering at all times, except when actively eating or drinking while stationary. Clean your hands often and thoroughly. Cover your mouth and nose when coughing and sneezing, and maintain physical distancing. Thank you.
What was your favorite animal?
I like the little dogs that were there and the cheetahs.
The little what?
The little dogs.
Oh, we'll have to go back and look at the video. I don't remember what they said they were. They were kind of cool looking. All right, y'all ready to go? It's tough to be a bug?
Yeah. Is that a ride?
It's a theater. Yeah. Okay, let's do it.
Bye. So we just went on Tough to Be a Bug. It's a show and you will have glasses because it's a
3D?
It's a 3D show. And you will get fake stung by the chair, and then at the end it says wait until the bugs leave, and then under your seat you just feel like something go behind you. And it was really fun, but the thing that I didn't like was when the bad guy came out. But and you will get a little bit wet. And yeah. So we are leaving the park, and when we were coming out over there, me and my dad felt a big raindrop. So I think it's gonna rain soon. Don't know. And we went on some fun rides, and our last was Tough to Be a Bug. So with that, thanks for watching. Bye.
Okay. What happened?
We just saw the tin.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How'd it make you feel?
It was really cool.
Yeah? Are you having a minute?
Yeah.
Like you saw a celebrity?
Yeah.
Did you say hi to him?
No.
Okay. All right. Come on. Let's go.